I'm Jenny Thacker with Simple Treasures, and I'm here to show you a few things about our show that's coming up. We have lots to see. We're going to show you a few vendors, a few different things you can buy, and give you a little bit of a sneak peek. So everybody who is entered and registered to watch this webinar has been entered to win the $50 gift certificate. Welcome to our first Simple Treasures webinar. We are really excited. We have a lot of fun things to show you. If you're new to Simple Treasures, you're gonna get a great behind the scenes look at what we do and a little bit about our story and how much fun we've had. We are in our 20th year this year. We're really excited about that. If you are one of our past customers, thank you, first of all. And you'll get a cool behind the scenes look today at some of our vendors and meeting some of the people, the faces that are behind the product. So let me tell you a little bit about Simple Treasures. So we're now in our 20th year, which is so exciting. We are gonna celebrate that at the November show. A little bit of history on us. We've started shows in 2000 in a little tiny building that fit about 10 booths in it. It was maybe, I want to say 13 vendors we had in the show. What got me started in this is as a little girl, I remember going shopping with my mother. She would always take me to the boutiques in the area. And I was so fascinated by that. And not only was I fascinated by that, I loved the me time that I got with my mom, the time that we got one-on-one together and we went and shopped, and it was such a fun tradition. As I think about the experience that I had with my mom shopping and how much fun we had together, I move over to my daughter, and now I'm able to take my daughter shopping and my kids shopping, and sometimes they love boutique week, and sometimes they don't because it means mom's missing. But we've had some really fun shopping experiences together, and I really wanted to recreate that feeling that I felt as a little girl for you, and I love the traditions that have come out of this. I've heard so many customers that have tradition stories that are amazing. So a little bit of background on Simple Treasures. The secret to Simple Treasures is our vendors, of course, but under one roof, we're bringing in 175 different vendors, different crafters, different talents, all kinds of different things. But if you think about it, it would take you days and days to go shop that many stores, and here you can come and shop it in an hour or two. So there's a lot of variety all in one place, and it's just an awesome way to shop, and as well as you can find the perfect gifts. I found some gifts for my home, for my friends, mothers, you know, everybody, that it's just a super personal gift. That is something that's really unique because it's locally handcrafted. Lots of things are one of a kind. And I can't tell you how many times people have come into my house and said, "Where did you get that?" And I know where I got it. I say, "Yeah, I got it to find it at Simple Treasures." And so that's a lot of fun to see how the product shines away from the show and to give the experience that you can come and shop that many small businesses at once. Our September show is going to be a little bit different. Our booths and everything will be down on the south end of Legacy Event Center. Our regular building is under construction. They are putting in a cement floor, which is really great for us. But it's under construction during our September date. So we'll be on the south end, and we'll have still 175 vendors. We'll have some outside, some inside. We're going to have lots for you to see. But just remember, we're on the south end. Who needs the perfect gift for mom? You know you have a mom that you can never find a gift for. So this is a great idea for the perfect gift. Hey, we have Doug Tangren here. He's with Nauvoo Remembered Jewelry. They've been at our shows here and there, and we're excited to have a sneak peek of what they're gonna bring to September show here. Doug, well, you wanna introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what you do and how you got there?
Sure, so our company's called Nauvoo Remembered, and we call it Nauvoo Remembered because our first jewelry started with stone from the original Nauvoo Temple. It's actually started back in the 1990s with my father. He loved all things Nauvoo and was a missionary there for many years. And while he was there, he was given a block of stone that was once a part of the original Nauvoo Temple. And he decided that he wanted to make himself a tie tack. So he found someone that could cut the stone into a little cabochon. And then someone said, "Well, can you make me a necklace?" So he made him a necklace, and then eventually a pair of earrings. So he made the jewelry out of the Nauvoo stone for many years, just with three simple settings, in one stone. He sold some in the bookstores there in Nauvoo, also at the Daughters of the Utah Pioneer, but mostly he just did it for friends and family.
Really?
If someone came into the house and they mentioned Nauvoo, he's in the back room making them a piece of jewelry for them to take home for it. So that's where it started.
Wow, Doug, I did not know that. So I'm so glad to hear your story today. Yes, awesome. Show us some of the things that you've got going on.
Well, yeah. So what eventually happened, unfortunately, my father passed away about 6 years ago, and he had stopped doing the jewelry for many years beforehand. And when he passed, we thought, we want to keep doing this just because it was part of our family and part of our heritage. And so I was going through his jewelry, and I noticed that he had stone from Aben, Nigeria, Palmyra, and a little bit of Salt Lake. And the thought occurred to us, you know, we could do this with any temple stone other than Nauvoo. And so that's where we started 6 years ago with those four temples. We created a little Etsy shop and we started adding more settings. And over time, we've gotten to the point now where we have probably about 75 different settings and men's and women's and everywhere in between there. And we've been able to find and create over 90 different stones from different temples.
Wow, 90.
90.
So everyone always asks, how did you get the stone?
You know, and I always tell people, I have 90 different temple stones and 90 different stories.
Okay.
And it really is that specific. But in general, what we found is that at a lot of the temple dedications outside of Utah, there's always scrap material. First of all you have to understand that all of our jewelry is made with scrap stone that either came off the temple during a repair or is left over from the original construction or renovation of the temple.
Mm-hmm.
So we found that outside of Utah, some of the open houses, they would have a box of just scraps that were being thrown away. They let people come in and take a little souvenir. We found that in a lot of areas, they would use some of the scrap stone and they would cut them up into little squares and give them to the youth like they did in Monticello and Bountiful and Mount Temp in Houston. And so we found as we went out at your show and many of the other shows that we've done, that people actually have temple stone. People were missionaries there and they picked up a souvenir. Someone knew someone who worked on the temple.
Right.
So every stone has a different story.
Awesome. Tell us about some of the settings you do.
Sure.
Tell us some of the details on how you put it all together.
Absolutely. So I couldn't bring all 90 today because that would just be too many. So I brought a dozen to kind of show you how our jewelry is made. It starts off with the scrap piece of stone. A lot of times we just have a little piece of stone. Sometimes we have a lot. And that's the beauty of this. We never know what we're gonna get or how long it's gonna last, but we cut it up and we make it into jewelry as long as it lasts. So today you're gonna see here on the table, this is stone from the Manti Temple. And this is from the Salt Lake Temple, Oakland, Jordan River, Ogden, San Diego, Logan, Nauvoo, St. George, Idaho Falls, Mesa, and Bountiful. Now, the first thing you're gonna notice is they're all very different. And that's because we beggars can't be choosers. We get stone from wherever we can. Sometimes it's the building itself. Sometimes it's a broken piece of tile from the floor or a broken handrail. It's just, as long as it's been a part of the temple or was there on site during the construction, we'll use it.
Awesome.
So we take these stones and we cut them up we have them cut into little cabochons. All of our settings take 10 by 8 millimeter cabochons. So we kind of have this flexibility of we have all these temples, we have all the stones are the same size, and then we have all these settings. So what happens like at Simple Treasures is you'll come to our table and you will see all 75 plus of our settings. And you'll see a big board, and it's kind of overwhelming, and we do that by design, with a picture of all 90 temples. And you'll say, you know what, these cufflinks, I like these cufflinks. Can I have these made in Bountiful stone? And we'll say, great. And we'll bring out our Bountiful stone, which I think is right here, and we'll let the customer actually pick the individual stone you want. Because even though the stones are different colors, every single cabochon is a different, has different shades.
Or it's got a little different colors in it and stuff like that.
And so the customer will pick out the setting, they'll pick out the temple and the cabochon, and then we'll actually set the stone for them in about 15 minutes. And they just come back after they've done some shopping.
Yep, so they can pick it out, shop, and it's ready for them when they finish. And this kind of gift, I gave something to my mother and tears. She was so impressed and it was such a it was an awesome moment for me to be able to give her something like that. And she just, it's one of those gifts that's a very emotional gift. It's a very
personal.
It's so personalized that it's just a fun thing. And that you can get it done right there at Simple Treasures is pretty sweet.
Yeah,
so.
And I never started out to be a jeweler. And this really started off as just a way to kind of stay close to my father. But it's really about that connection. And when we find someone that has a connection with the temple, especially some of our obscure ones that you probably wouldn't think about, it's a special moment for them, it's a special moment for us, and we always have them come back and talk about, I gave it to my mother for Mother's Day, and she cried, and we're like, we guarantee a cry, we really do. I mean, it's that personal, it's that touching. It's not just jewelry. It's a tie to the temple and all the things that happen in there. There's nothing sacred or holy about the stone. It is scrap. It's being discarded. We have a little pillow that one of your vendors made for us. It says, no temples were harmed in the making of our jewelry. And that is true. We don't harm the temples. This is just literally pieces being thrown away. But it helps, especially during this time when the temples are closed and people can't go. It helps keep the temple close, and if it reminds you of the thing in the temple that are sacred and are special, then we feel like it's a bonus for us, because that's really what we like to see and the experience we like to have.
All right, Insider Secret, this is your place to get fall and Halloween decor. I'm hearing around that stores are having a hard time getting it in stock. Everything is delayed because of COVID, but Simple Treasures is going to have plenty of fall and Halloween decor. We're going to see some coming up. We have Megan Crandall here with Wishing Well Wreaths. I can't say that 10 times, but I can say it once.
That's good.
Megan, we're so happy to have you here for the webinar today. And we're just lucky to have her in the show. She is so talented. I've never seen anybody make wreaths and et cetera the way she does. I love the way she throws in all the different elements of, elements and textures and colors into everything she does. I'm going to give her a minute to just tell us her story. So,
the real story behind how I really got started was my mother passed away from cancer about 10 years ago. But before she passed away, I could not do this. I could not do flowers. She helped me decorate my house, and I could not do any of this.
I don't believe it.
So I kind of feel like when I'm downstairs in my craft room, that a little part of her is just kind of saying, okay, maybe you should put a flower there, or maybe this would look good here. So I really love that crafting. I think the beautiful thing about crafting is that it helps me so much emotionally. I have to have a project. If I don't have a project, I want to go stay in bed all day or whatever.
Oh, and guess what? So. We've all needed projects lately, right?
Yes.
So what I'm really excited about is to see the creativity that's coming to the show, because all of these vendors have had 5 months of quarantine. So we're going to see some awesome stuff.
Yes,
and
we are.
I want to say their inventory is probably going to be way higher than normal. So we're going to have more of it. Just because they've had a few months in between shows, and a lot of the other events have canceled, and so you're going to see a lot more inventory, a lot more creativity.
My wreaths are definitely my biggest thing that
so
I do.
They are so pretty.
I like to call myself the ultimate wreath lady. I put more into mine. I want the cute little objects going on in the sides.
And, who would have thought to put trash bags in the wreath? Wow.
Yes. Trash bags in the wreath for the fun little cape. And I just like to be creative. And, where I find a centerpiece, I'm like, all of a sudden, my head starts building a wreath around it.
Awesome.
So let me show you some of the fun little things that I have besides my wreaths. See here, this one is a really fun one. It's a witch hat, and she's got her cute little leggies down there. And I just think, whoever has that on their door, I'm going to make them happy. That's another thing I love about it, is you're making somebody happy. I've tried to expand my horizons and do other things. I've got these really fun pumpkin stands that, you can play with. These ones, actually, I have ones like this that actually stand up.
Okay, so you don't need an easel or anything behind this. It's freestanding.
You don't need an
easel.
Awesome. I also have other ones that are similar to this that you can hang up. I also
have show them that.
These fun little, I like to do a bunch of different things. So here's a fun little witch broom, and it's got the fun little bows and the fun little saying and ribbon. I mean, I'm a ribbon addict.
All the texture and color. You are yes. So talented.
Another thing that I love to do that I'm just, I love these cute little gnomes. They're cute little sock gnomes.
How
and
fun.
These ones have cute little Halloween on them. So there's a mummy and a vampire. And down here, I've got Frankenstein. And then I just have some plain ones that are just bats and things like that. My other thing that I think is really, really cool that I saw on YouTube was these fun little season sorters. So what you can do is, so it's autumn right now, right? So you would have it up like this, autumn, okay. Well, it's winter now, so you can, you know, turn it around and now it's winter.
Awesome.
You know, and you just kind of go around just like that. And
how
I just
fun.
Thought that was
yep,
kind of a
really
fun, cute idea. I just love to play with textures and colors and flowers. It can be December outside, but it is spring downstairs in my basement.
Yay, we all need a little spring.
Yes.
Awesome. Megan, thank you so much for coming with
well,
us and sharing this today.
Me.
Hope you all come out and support the small, hundreds of small businesses at Simple Treasures. There's 175 vendors. You're supporting 175 local families when you shop with Simple Treasures. And so, come out and support Megan and
I would love
September
to see you.
15th through the September 15th through the 19th. We open on Tuesday. So this event is a really great way for you to support the local economy, and you get something unique and specific to what you need. And so it's a great way to support the local economy as you get to shop 175 booths at once. The vendors really, really appreciate every sale. There has been so many events cancel on a lot of these vendors all year. And so they've had not very many places that they could sell. And so they could really use your support, and we appreciate you coming out. It's a really great way to support the local economy. Every dime you spend there gets circulated back into this local economy 7 times. So it's a great way to support the local economy, support the local families and vendors that are involved, and we hope that you come away with plenty of things that you love. Okay, right now safety's on everyone's mind. We want to make sure this event is safe. The health department has given us the thumbs up, and we are good to go. We're going to do everything we can to keep this a safe event for you. Our vendors and staff will all be wearing masks. We will be sanitizing highly touched surfaces. We will be sanitizing the baskets as they come back to you. We've also extended a day, so we have extra shopping time, which is good on all ends, right? So we have extra shopping time so that we can spread out the crowd a little bit so we can enjoy this event. And we hope that you all come and enjoy and escape from your worries here at Simple Treasures. If you are new to Simple Treasures, there's lots of reasons for you to make sure you get there. We have over 175 vendors coming. So that means lots and lots of cute, crafty stuff, lots of home decor, and we have so much variety there. It's crazy. Another reason as a newcomer, it's a fun, fun tradition to start with your family, with your friends. And I have lots of people that love to come in and get some alone time and just shop through all the booths and enjoy. So lots of reasons to come and shop Simple Treasures. There's lots of great deals also. We really have a lot of vendors that have kept their prices at a really reasonable price point. And so you'll find some great deals, you'll find some great gifts, especially unique things if you're looking for something that not everyone has, not something that you don't find at Walmart or Target or anything like that. So you can find all kinds of unique stuff here. I hope you're all as excited as I am for showtime. We're all counting the days down to September show. Insider secret, it's a little like Disneyland. So you kind of uncover it in layers. You go through the first time and then you go through the second time. You see lots of different things. Vendors are restocking daily and there's always, always plenty to see. We have lots of customers that'll come in 4 or 5 times during the same show. Okay, September 15th through the 19th, we open on Tuesday. Regular admission is Tuesday 2 to 8. Wednesday through Friday, 10 to 8, Saturday, 10 to 6 in Farmington, Legacy Event Center on the south end this show. We can't wait to see you.